welcome to Saturday Scene. This morning my guests are top makeup artist Barbara Daly, brother and sister singing duo Mac and Katie Cassoon, and fresh from Salisbury Hill, Peter Gabriel will be joining me.
Climbing up on Salisbury Hill, I could see the city light. Wind was blowing, time stood still.
You're listening to this week's number 16 sound in the chart, and it comes from a man who's achieved a solo success both sides of the Atlantic, Peter Gabriel. Hello.
Hi.
Peter, and welcome. Now, Peter, I know that everybody watching will be aware that up until 1975 you were frontman and vocalist for Genesis. I don't really want to talk about that. I'd like to ask you what happened after you left. What did you start to do?
Well, I disappeared for a while and sort of got out of the music business and began to follow up some of the things that I'd lost touch with. Did some yoga, meditation things, gardening, making babies, sort of pleasant activities.
You learnt to play the piano as well, I gather?
Well, I used to play piano a bit, but I improved it marginally.
Now then, at some stage along that, in the middle of all that, you decided that you wanted to get a solo career going and wanted to record. I suppose it must have been very important then to find the right person to work with, the right producer. How did you go about that?
Well, I saw a few people, both over here and in America, and eventually I came across Bob Ezrin, who was a somewhat unlikely combination, as neither I was interested in his track record or he in mine.
Really?
But we got on very well, and he was enthusiastic about the songs, and sort of his criticisms and the suggestions were very much what I felt the album should be anyway. So we tried some things and I felt it worked well, so we went ahead.
And you went over to Toronto to a studio that he'd designed to record in?
That's right.
Now, I know that you had some very top session musicians on this album, and something slightly unusual happened, because when you went off on the road, they asked to accompany you, didn't they? Which is quite unusual, because often you don't move those sort of guys out of the studio, do you?
No, it was very encouraging for me, because they got involved in some of the songs, and I think they put a lot more into it. It felt more like a band than the average session album, which can sometimes sound a little cold.
Yes, I know what you mean. But the fact that they are such top session guys, does this mean that them being part of your band is a temporary arrangement?
Yeah, I mean, a lot of them have other things that they're doing. Mm. But I hope maybe that a core of those people will be able to sort of work with me on future things. So I have to see what happens, really.
Now, you're enjoying great success with Salisbury Hill at the moment. Now, Salisbury Hill is a hill near Bath, I gather.
It is. It's just above where I live, in fact. And it's a place I like to go and sit and think. And there's a lot of local legend attached, which is one story. King Bladud, who's allegedly ninth king of England, went to Greece to study under Pythagoras, returned to set up the first British Druid school near Bath, built seven temples on the seven hills around the city, and on Salisbury Hill, which is a strange sort of flat triangular shaped hill, he's alleged to have built a temple to Apollo, where it's said that he died trying to fly like an eagle from the top of the temple. A lot of historians would dismiss all this as rubbish, but
that's very good.
John Wood the Younger, actually, who designed a lot of Bath, made a sort of historical account in which he expostulated this theory.
So did all this go to make you want to write this song, Salisbury Hill?
Well, very little, but it was sort of background, and it's a nice place to go and let your imagination ramble.
Now, Salisbury Hill's doing well for you in the American charts. It's number 65. Your album, Peter Gabriel, is in the top 30. So I gather that a visit must be imminent.
To the States, you mean? Well, in fact, we just toured over there.
Mm.
But I probably have to go back if the record sort of continues to
for
move
radio
a bit.
Stuff.
Yeah, for radio work, yeah.
Now, we've got a copy of the album. In fact, we've got six copies of the album to give away, which I'm going to ask you to sign.
Fine.
And I've dreamt up a competition, which I think is quite hard, but it'd be quite interesting, I think. Towards the end of Salisbury Hill, you say Lou Fooey. Is that right? Is that what you say?
This is correct.
Right. Now, I was going to ask you what Lou Fooey is. I mean, it must mean something.
Well, it's a strange relation of chop suey, but it is actually something which makes sense when played backwards.
Lufui is something when, yes, when it's backwards.
Right.
Right, so I thought we'd ask people to write in saying, what is Lufui?
Right.
And the first six correct answers will receive an album, and you'll have to tell me before you go what it really is.
Fine.
Okay? Right, so we've given them a slight clue. Here's the address for the entries. It's Saturday Scene, London Weekend Television, London SE 99. Thank you very much for coming to talk to me, Peter.
Fine, thank you.
Very nice to see you. And after the break, it'll be time for the Clue Club. Welcome back. You're listening to Rhapsody, the latest single by the Four Seasons, who have enjoyed such a successful British tour here with Frankie Valli, and I'm sure they'll soon be back in the charts with that record. I'd like to thank all my guests, and in fact we've just got time to read out a few requests, starting with Hugh.
Well, this one says, a very happy birthday to Jacqueline Scott of 48 Perthcourt, Camberwell Hill, London. Her birthday was yesterday. This comes with lots of love from Mummy, Paul, Victor and Janice.
Thanks very much, Hugh. And David's got a card there as well.
This one says, I'd like to wish a very happy birthday to Linda Newman of 2 St Michael's Road, Ashford, Middlesex. Her birthday is today. This comes with lots of love from Mummy and Nanny.
Barbara, we didn't have a card to give you to read, did we?
Especially as I can't read yet.
But I'd like to just quickly mention, Barbara, that you've made out a skin chart with lots of tips, beauty tips in. If people would like to write in with a stamped addressed envelope, we will, of course, send them a copy of your leaflet, which includes all sorts of useful tips, I'm sure.
It does, I hope.
You've got to go and write it now, I suppose.
Yeah, it takes care of the weekend.
Right. Okay, let's move on to Peter, and I'll ask you to read that card, Peter.
Right, this card is happy birthday to Claire Smith, 16 on May 25th, and her sister Maxine, whose birthday on the 29th of May. And they're at 15 Todd's Walk, Andover Road, London, N7. And this request comes with lots of love from Mummy.
Thank you, Peter. Peter, I'm surprised, I mentioned this earlier, I'm surprised that this is your first appearance on British television, chatting.
Well, sort of, very nearly almost.
Very nearly almost?
Yes.
I thought it was the first.
Well, there was one afternoon thing previously.
Very nearly almost.
Right, no, it's still a novel experience for me.
Right, well, we're very glad that you came along and chatted to us. Thanks. Mac, would you like to read that card out?
Here's a special Saturday Scene hello to Matthew Ives, 38 Beresford Road, Chingford, London, East 4. This comes with love from his cousin Daniel Smith, who lives at 27 Hanbury Close, Cheshunt, in Hertfordshire.
Thank you very much. I'm afraid we haven't got time to hear from you, Katie. Thank you very much, though. I'll leave you with the number one sound from Denise Williams, and I'll see you next week. Goodbye.